This Canon Powershot A70 has a faulty image sensor. The photos it takes are all black, and from what I can tell, this is a common problem for these. These early model Powershots are known to fail just like this. But rather than becoming junk, this camera from 2003 has found a place on my shelf of tech oddities. I love that the main camera firmware is just a DOS program called camera.exe, because this camera runs a variant of MS-DOS on an x86-based CPU. This is normally all hidden from the end user, so let's have a peek under the hood and see what's going on. Which also raises the question, what else can this thing do? I really enjoy finding vintage hacks. I like going and searching for modding communities around different devices. There's not very much for these early Powershots, but I did find a Russian forum called ixbt.com, and there's a single thread discussing modding these older x86-based cameras. Looking through the posts, and there's quite a few different links to things people have shared. Unfortunately, most of these pages are now gone, but this is where the Internet Archive comes in extremely handy. They archive not only the pages themselves, but sometimes they also archive the software that's linked from a web page, including some of the homebrew software that was made to run on this camera. I also found this page specifically about the Powershot A70 that's still up today, by Rhea, who was big in the Canon modding scene. The page is not in English, and it's hosted in the Czech Republic. Why are there so many hackers and modders from Central and Eastern Europe? Fortunately, modern translation tools have become really good, and this page contains lots of really good info. It turns out this camera is running ROM-DOS, an embedded version of MS-DOS. There's no command prompt, of course. The only clue that reveals what's going on inside this camera is the way the firmware update system works. Firmware updates are done by copying a folder to a compact flash card. The camera then detects the software on the card and adds an extra item to the camera's menu. The update software is actually a DOS program that does the firmware flashing. Modders worked out that it was possible to replace the installer software with something else and get it to run. There are some very strict requirements though. You need to include an .ini file with the same name as the software. This is what creates the menu item. Inside the .ini file is where you put the menu item's name, and this must be exactly 15 characters, even if that means padding it out with spaces. And only 4 new menu items can be shown at any one time. This camera doesn't exactly have a standard BIOS, and if you do try to run regular DOS software, the camera will just shut down. Trust me, I tried. It is, however, possible to write DOS software to run specifically on this camera. It will often involve using the camera's own display API to be able to show text or even graphics on the screen. This resulted in a number of useful DOS programs that have been written for this camera. The first one I'm trying here is called DirView. This shows all the different drives mounted in the camera. The A drive holds the firmware, there's camera.exe. The B drive holds some customization files, like the startup logo and camera sounds. The C drive appears to be empty, and the D drive is the compact flash card itself. There are options to copy files and do a few other filing functions. This is a neat little program, especially for something that doesn't have a command prompt. I also found a battery info program that shows the battery voltage and the temperature inside the camera. It can also show a few raw analog to digital converter outputs as well. It's not really clear what these are meant to be for. There's also a SysTool program with some basic utilities, including messing about with some color mixing and making some sound. There's a memory search function, useful if you want to do some debugging. And there's a prime number benchmark to give us an idea of the power of the CPU. There's also a way to make the compact flash card bootable. This allows you to run the camera.exe firmware directly from the compact flash card. This is very useful for firmware modders who want an easy way to run and test custom firmware patches to the original firmware. There's also some photographic related homebrew software available, such as this depth of field calculator. This looks quite in depth. There's also a histogram program for reviewing photos. These are not so useful for me with a broken camera, so it's some of the other software that I'm more interested in seeing. I found a Pong demo. It's not playable, it's just the computer playing itself, but there's something oddly satisfying about seeing this. There's also a game called 15. This is a tile slider, and I really don't like this game. And there's also a text file reader software. So if you've ever wanted to turn your camera into an ebook reader, now it's possible. But the big software I've been wanting to try out is Tetris. And it's a very playable version of Tetris running on this camera. It's probably not going to displace original Tetris on the Game Boy for me, but I really like it and it really pleases me to see it on here. And this is exactly the sort of thing that I enjoy finding. But I also found a couple more things as well. There are two scene demos available for this camera. One is called Canon Space, and this runs, well, kind of slow. It seems to top out at about 2 frames per second, because no method was found to address the pixels directly. Instead, the only thing that was found is an API function that can draw rectangles, making anything you do with graphics rather inefficient. Which makes this second scene demo all the more impressive. This is a second reality tribute by Raya. It's short but sweet, and I really enjoy seeing it running on this camera. This was entered into the Chaos Constructions 2005 demo party, and it won first place in its division for mobile demos. In the years following this model, Canon eventually switched from x86-based CPU cores to the more common ARM-based CPU cores, and it looks like ARM-based Canon cameras also have their own modding scene around them, with something called Canon Hack Development Kit, or CHDK. If I get one of those models and it turns out to be interesting, I might explore that one day in the future. I've got a number of new videos coming up on the channel. Playing Tetris on here has made me think that maybe it's time to explore some game consoles, like for example the Game Boy. That could make a really good future video. Thanks for watching this short but sweet exploration into the early Canon modding scene. But that's it for now, and I'll see you next time.